Hello and welcome to the overview of the Clik Cert ELEC app. We will go through how you log on to the app, create a certificate, how you download certificates onto your device and upload them back to the office. We will also look at templates and applying a template from the app. So let's get started. Firstly, download the app from the App Store or Play Store. Once that's done, tap on the app logo and tap on login. You will then be prompted for a PIN code. This PIN code would have been given to you by your office. If you need the PIN number, then go to the NICEIC cert software, click Edit, Settings, Field User, and you will see your PIN number. Once that's accepted, enter your username and password that will have been set up on the NICEIC cert software. Now tap Login and then tap the Start Sync button to do your first sync. If you have used a device before with the same user, you will be prompted with this box that asks to confirm if this will be your primary device. You can select yes or no, but if this is the device you will be mostly using for field mode, then please select yes. Now the sync has finished, you will be asked to download templates. Do this to grab the latest certificate changes. Now you're in, and if the office has sent you some certificates, you will see them in the cert list. If you need to download certs from the office, you just hold and pull down from the top and tap Start Sync. Now we're going to simply tap on one of these certificates and fill one in. We're going to be looking at the DCR18 that was sent from the office. As you can see, some of this has already been filled in for us, which is a really good start for the engineer. So now what the engineer needs to do is fill in some of the certificate. If we go to the top left, you will see three bars and you'll be able to select a section that you can fill in. We're going to choose page 3 and use the first part. So here we are, we're going to tick some of these boxes and some of them we're going to put as NA. Once we're happy with that, we just click save. And now we can have a little look at the circuit details by clicking on the three bars in the top left again and finding circuit details. And this is where you can add a board and add your circuits. So the first thing I'm going to show you is how you add the board. So where the current board is, we just click where the plus sign and that will create a DB2 for us. Now if we want to select the first board again, we just click on the drop down arrow and select DB001 at the bottom and click done. So now in this board we need to create some circuits. So what we're going to do is use the circuit wizard by clicking on the drop down arrow near the circuit details on the right hand side. So as you can see, we have two options, add using circuit wizard and add a three phase circuit straight away. We're going to use the add using circuit wizard. We can put in a number of lines, number of circuits and the circuit start number. Once we're happy with that, we can go create circuits and they will display on our device. Now to add detail to the circuit, you just click on one of the circuits and start putting in a description, type of wiring and reference method. So as you can see, you can use magnifying glasses and we're going to use this to select a reference method. And that will automatically put it in. Now once you've filled in your circuit, what you need to do is then go on to the next circuit and you can just click on the right arrow just below done to go to the next circuit. However, what you can do to make it easier, and if the circuit is very similar, you can copy that circuit, go to the next page and select paste. And just change the circuit number. Once you're happy with your circuits, just click on done and then we'll click on save and your circuits will be in the board. Now another thing you can also do is on the top right hand side is the three dots. And you can NA order the blank fields within the circuit by just literally pressing the NA All Distribution Boards Circuit Details. And again, just to confirm it, click it again, and that will fill in NA in all blank spaces on this particular board. You'll also notice when you click on the three dots, there is NA All Blank Fields for the entire certificate. Okay, so let's come out of that and create a completely new certificate from the device. So if we click on the three bars on the top left-hand side and close this certificate, it will ask to save before exiting, and that's what we'll do. So now let's click on the three bars again, and you'll notice there is an option called Create Cert. So from here, you'll see a list of all the certificates that you can create. You'll also notice a little star sign next to some of them. And this is to make some of them your favorites, so you can easily select them when you come in again. So let's just do that for the DCR18. So as you can see, it's now highlighted as one of my favorites. So the next time I log in, I can quickly click on that particular certificate. Now I want to create a completely blank certificate, so I'm just going to tap on the DCR18. And I can start filling it in. So what I can do is I can go and click on the magnifying glass. I can find us as a contractor. And I can also do details of a client on the magnifying glass to find one of my customers. So you can see it's really easy to fill in if you do have your customers to hand. Now what we're going to do is we're going to quickly go to another page by clicking on the three bars in the top left. And just quickly again, just tapping on the boxes that we wish to fill in. Once you're happy with what you've done with the certificate, you can simply just click on the three bars in the top left hand side and click close. You'll be prompted to save before exiting, and all you need to do is tap on save. Okay, so now let's go back to the three bars and go to templates. Now what may happen is your office may send you some templates so you can quickly add certificates that are already pre-filled in. So let's go to templates and select small dwelling. So we could be in a small dwelling that might have some defaults already fixed in for us. So what we'll do now is we'll just fill in the rest as we would with a create certificate, or if we've got a certificate downloaded from the office. So again, you just go onto your boxes, tap in, click save, and then we can close that certificate. Now let's go back to the certificate list. And now we can think about uploading some of those certificates back to the office. Now to do that, all you do is hold down the certificate you wish to send back, and it will be ticked in the little circle next to the DCR18. You'll see a tick, and then you can start selecting more to send back to the office. Once you're happy with your selection, just click on the cloud with the arrow pointing up on the top right hand side, and then tap upload. Upload complete. Great. They're now ready back at the office for them to receive and look at those certificates that you've created. Okay, that's it for the overview of the Clik Cert ELEC app. Thanks very much for listening.